Thanks for joining me again. This is just going to be a simple little river scene. Could be anywhere really. I like to imagine it somewhere in the Scottish Highlands. I'm just going to go a bit of ultramarine, just a little bit of sky you can see there, not a lot. And then I'm just going to do very limited palette, I think, on this one. Maybe just the three colours: raw sienna, burnt umber, and ultramarine. So this is just like a mass of trees in the background. I've just caught the light yellow there. Not to worry. Just trying to vary it slightly as I go up, down here, and then back up the other side of the landscape. And amongst those, just imagine just a few like just trunks here and there. Scrape a few out for this. You see there where this, obviously this raw sienna, I put this on the palette last night. This obviously hasn't quite dried yet. But you do get these nice effects. You're almost using it fresh out of the tube like this. I do love this effect. It's just that I hate having to waste it. I used to use it just all the time like that. But it's just having to waste it when it dries. So I just got used to using it dry off the palette. Let's get a little bit of river work. Put a few more trunks and stuff in. And then anything I don't like, I'll just paint straight over it. Like that. Just paint straight over it if you don't like it. I'm just twisting the height, just trying to get all sorts of different kinds of effects. Remember, most important to just constantly vary the colour. Don't have it just one monotonous colour all the way along. As long as you keep varying it. Most things, most scenes you can keep interesting. The paper stretched a bit, so I'm just going to pull it tight. So it's nice and flat, and then I'm going to clean the brush. I'm just going to switch to the flap and let's just pop a few fence posts up there. So I want these nice and dark, so I'm just going to go ultramarine and burnt umber. Not too much water, but I just want it nice and dark. And I'm just going to start somewhere there, and I'm just going to do some posts. Few little cross pieces here and there. Get your finger in there and just mess it up a little bit. Clean the hay, take the excess off on the tea towel. I'm going to go raw sienna. So you know, we've got all the darks there, so let's get a bit of lighter colour underneath. Ultramarine, just to vary it. Like I say, just constantly varying it. And so even just with three colours, you can get quite a lot of variation. There's going to be a river coming round here, so I'm just going to just get this. I might put the water in now, so I'll know where they are. There we go, I've cleaned the brush, take the excess off on the tea towel. And I'm just going to go into the blue. Just a touch of raw sienna. And then sort of start off up there and sweeps round, something like that. I didn't really need to clean the brush down, just did it out of habit, I think. Just getting these sort of dark muddy bits now as you come down to the bank. And real dark bits down by, like the bottom down there. Maybe even a few rocks, use the card, piece of card, and you can pop a few little rocks down there by the water's edge. Now then, over on the other side, then bringing that down. See, because we're coming down the hill, that's the way the strokes are going, sort of down like this. Somewhere like that, and then back up. So that looks quite steep now, the way it's coming down. Again, it's getting nice and dark right by the bank. Maybe even a few rocks just there as well. Back to the car. Bigger there, and pulling the bottom of them across. You can have a couple of rocks actually in the water themselves. Pop the colour down, dark colour. Something like that. It's just to make that a bit more bluey. Just making the water a bit more bluey. Just sweep that round again. Might just put I'm just going to put a little figure up there, so just someone walking off. Little dog by him. I'll leave it at that, I think, before I overdo it slightly. A couple of little birds up in the sky. I've done them a bit too even, actually. I didn't really think very hard about that. They're a bit too dark. If you don't like it, you can always rub it out. So and you just need a bit of cleaner bit of tissue than what I've got, and see how they rub out. Just damp your brush. Bit of tissue, and off they come. Let's just do the other one, just to prove it's not a fluke. Just dab it. Let's see, use your eraser tissue. Let's try that again then. I think I had a bit too much water on the brush. I'm just bringing that down to a fine line. Put them very, very fine. Well, you've got a bit of life there, so I'd rather have them a bit further away, I think. And a bit more in the trees. Oh, I'll have them there. And all I've got left to do. I'm looking now, I can see the light reflecting. Yeah, I can see that that's dry almost, is it? As good as. Got my signature on there. And that's the other one. Right, so let's see what it looks like with the mounts on. There's the paints with the mounts on. Started as usual with the sky, but can see very little of the blue in the background. You can see I've used various strokes. Remember just the three colours, just to create this sort of mishmash of trees in the background, sort of semi-abstract really. A few fingernails as well in there, just to keep it, suggest the twigs and branches. Try to keep it interesting by constantly varying the colour. Same on the right hand side as well. The land sort of comes down steeply there onto the banks of the river. Bit of scraping out for the rocks. And a few more on the other side, and some big ones right in the foreground. I've put the river in now, the paint's broken slightly as I've put the strokes in. Makes it look like the surf as there's the water sort of swishing around all over the place. Up on the hill there we go, a little figure walking his dog. And our fence post put in with the flat brush. And you can see here where the sort of dollops of raw sienna have come up on the brush. It's not quite dried on my palette, but I quite like the effect. So overall then, it shows you don't need to use many colours to make a nice little painting. Just the three here. Thanks for watching, I hope you like it. Keep practicing. Any questions please ask, and I'll see you again soon.